Ngowi TV, informed economies and business perspective.
We have to invest on invest in youth. We have to reduce the fertility rate. That is very important to reduce the dependency rate and also to improve the education of the young people if we want to get the demographic dividend from the youth.
And the last thing is governance and accountability. When we're talking about governance and accountability, most of the people tend to think about corruption. And when people talk about corruption, they just think about the government as if the private sector doesn't have that, right? Okay. So it's not about that. But it's when we're talking about governance and accountability, it is also about increasing efficiencies.
For you to motivate the private sector to invest, they need to be sure that they're going to produce quality working population. But also the private sector can attempt and put money where they believe that this population will begin to be, yes, the consumer, because the consumer and the professor of economics will tell you here, demand is only effective when you can pay the price.
In the first place, it's good to understand when you want to move to graduate as a country from where we are now to middle income economy, we have to know exactly where we are now. Exactly, we are now a low income country within the World Bank grouping of countries. And you know, within the low income countries, really there are groups. There are two groups mainly. We have a lower level, low income, and then high level income group. So whereas we want to graduate from low income to middle income, we have to know what are the key issues.
I would like to take this opportunity to extend our voice to other stakeholders, specifically organizations that are providing similar services like AR, the medical insurance companies in Tanzania, that it is a high time now. They consider the aspect of family planning as an inclusion into the family, into the medical insurance schemes, so that many more Tanzanians can have access to the family planning benefits and enjoy those specific benefits.
Almost 50% of Tanzanians, more than 50% of Tanzanians, are below the age of 20, and more than 65% of Tanzanians are below the age of 25. So actually, some of us who are sitting here in this room, we are part of the minority of this country. This country is very young. It has a youthful population. So if we don't do anything, if we don't play our role when it comes to dealing with young people, we are missing out on very big opportunities.
Tanzania, I would like to take this opportunity to extend our appreciation to the technical team of family planning in Tanzania for inviting us and making sure that we participate in this dialogue this morning. Thank you very much. We further extend our appreciation to the Johns Hopkins University, the AFP unit specifically for making a lot of efforts to ensure that they partner with AR Tanzania in delivering family planning services to our community. Our organization, AR, is the largest healthcare organization operating in the region of West Africa, specifically in the countries of Tanzania, Kenya, Uganda. We have of recent extended our services toward the south of the continent, and we are now available in Zambia. We also provide healthcare solutions throughout the countries of Rwanda and Burundi through the affiliation that we have with the specific providers in those countries. We've been in this market for over 31 years. The market, perhaps it's an actual market, and looking at combining it with the potential market, we've been providing healthcare solutions to clients ranging from the large corporate organizations to individual family units. I can see some of the people who are AR members in this group, and I'm really appreciating that you are members. I can see members from PSCI in General Health, FBME. I can see Mr. Mafuru. Thank you for being one of our loyal AR members. The services that we're providing currently covers over 300 lives in the region. And out of that, we have over 100 members covered in Tanzania. Our focus, especially in 2017, as an organization, is to develop unique products that provide medical solutions to the local Tanzanians through the microinsurance schemes, and we've started providing that. And again, through the same scheme, we've really incorporated the aspect of family planning such that so many Tanzanians can have access to that specific facilities. Maybe briefly on our partnership with the John Hopkins University on the aspect of family planning delivery. In the year between 2012-2013, the John Hopkins University sustained discussions with our AAR on the family planning aspects. Remember, by then, and even now, most of the medical insurance companies would list family planning on the area of exclusions, that it is not covered on the medical insurance. Now the discussion expanded, and in the year 2014, AAR acknowledged that there's a strong link between the family upkeep and stress among employees, and that was through our employees wellness program. And by then we had about 10 corporate clients that have registered under our employees wellness program. Within short time, we realized the benefits of incorporating or integrating family programs, family planning programs into our wellness program. And therefore, last year in 2016, we made a strategic decision to integrate family planning into our health insurance programs. And that gave access to many of our corporate and individual clients to enjoy the family planning as a benefit. And as we speak, as of yesterday, we have over 41 corporate clients with about 7,000 lives enjoying family planning as a part of the benefits. I'm very proud to say within AAR, we have 11 employees who are standing out there as voluntary champions to extend the gospel of family planning in our communities through various groups. And they're doing that voluntarily. I am one of them. We have been trained by various organizations, including Ingenda Health, PSI, and the John Hopkins University in Tanzania, on how best can we deliver that messages to your communities. I would like to confess that the integration, the inclusion of family planning into our medical health schemes have really provided us with a lot of benefits. We are now seeing quite a reduction of our maternity costs. We are now seeing lower maternal death and maternal complications, and we're also seeing quite a number of safer children deliveries in Tanzania through the pool of about 100 members that we're covering in our medical schemes. I would like to take this opportunity to extend our voice to other stakeholders, specifically our organizations that are providing similar services like AR, the medical insurance companies in Tanzania, that it is a high time now. They consider the aspect of family planning as an inclusion into the family, into the medical insurance schemes, so that many more Tanzanians can have access to the family planning benefits and enjoy those specific benefits. I would like to say that we are committed to support the family planning movements in Tanzania. We are committed to support the movement by various stakeholders, including the Johns Hopkins University, Gender Health, PSI, and the other stakeholders. We are doing so now. We'll continue to do so. And we are doing that for the better Tanzania.